Hi, I am Lisa Sersoli, author of the book, A Memoir as Nora Jo Fades Away, Confessions of a Caregiver, and I'm here to give all you caregivers in the world, you fabulous, beautiful caregivers, a few little tips, a few little survival tips, just for you. They're just for you. I've been with my gram for 2.5 years. I should say she's been with my family and I, which is actually comprised of my husband, my 5-year-old daughter, and his 15-year-old son. So it's an interesting dynamic. We have 2 dogs too. Anyway, there's everybody. The first year and a half I was on my own. I was doing some odd jobs and taking care of Jazz, and she was 3 and 4, and I was completely on my own for 1.5 years, and I felt really closed off. I also felt like I wasn't allowed to ask for help because ultimately it was my idea to move her in. So I felt really responsible that it was also my job to keep it together and be the number one person to take care of her. And after 1.5 years, I was so burnt out. I was thin, I wasn't eating. I most certainly was depressed, even though I didn't say those words out loud or go seek medical attention. I felt like I didn't have time to seek medical attention. That's another big thing that we can't forget to do as caregivers. So what happened was I actually convinced my husband that we needed to hire somebody to come in 25 hours a week to help us. And 25 hours a week, think about it, that's like noon to 5. It's not even a full day's work. But, you know, what it did for me was I can get some writing done, I can make phone calls, I can do conference calls, I can go to the gym, I can take my kid to the park if I need to take my kid to the park. And then what it also did for my gram, I might add, this is an interesting sidebar, is that she also had another person to interact with. So the two of us weren't seeing each other. We were seeing each other every day, but we weren't being dragged down by each other or by my exhaustion, I should say. Our assistant came up with this great idea that one night a week, my husband and I go on a date night, and I was like, one night a week is way too much. We don't even do that one night out of the month. That being said, she was like, you're doing it. You're going on date night one night a week. So I actually talk about that in the book, and I think I say that caregiving is a team sport. We get a grandma sitter one night a week, and we go out, and sometimes it's really romantic, and my husband discovers, to his dismay, that I still like things like food and sex and, you know, movies and all these things that are fun for real people. And in fact, I don't need to talk about dead relatives and bodily functions all night long. It's really super cool. But sometimes I'm just super tired, and we lay at his sister's house and watch American Idol, and that's just what it is. That's date night. Some nights, date night actually entails going to the gym and doing a little bit of yoga. And that's the other thing I discovered. For 1 year now, I have been super regimented in that I do yoga 2 days a week. It sounds really funny if any of you Hollywood people are listening to me, but back in Michigan, that's a lot. So anyway, I've incorporated two days a week of yoga into my life and hula hooping. And then I also got this DVD called Zumba because my kid loves to dance. And my gram loves watching us dance because, did you know, we're better than anybody. We're the best dancers in the world. She also loves watching me do yoga because I'm crazy bendy. Those are her words, I'm crazy bendy. So I have discovered a few things that I can do for myself, and even whether my gram is in the room or not in the room, that are literally saving me. The other thing she really likes to do is she likes to go out to dinner, and I didn't really realize that. And you know, hey, I like to go out to dinner. So we make it a point twice a month to take gram out to dinner. Regardless of what kind of state she's in, as long as she's not in any kind of physical pain. For example, one night she got her makeup on because she's of the generation that's always wearing makeup, and she used my daughter's blue magic marker to put her eyebrows on instead of an eyebrow pencil, but we were already in the car before we noticed, so so we in fact went to dinner with Graham having fluorescent blue eyebrows. But anyway, such is the life of a caregiver.